Good day and night to you, dear listener. What is Land of God and what is its purpose? Where and how can you build it? Why is the urgency for Land of God today? Where do my inspiration and knowledge come from? In 2015, I began an artistic research with the aim of creating a social structure that would lead every follower of this structure to well-being and prosperity. What started only with the social structure ended with the creation of a whole new type of society, a new reality that I call Land of Good. The first challenge was to recognize that everyone has different ideas about happiness and prosperity. And the second challenge was, despite those differences, still to be able to build a society of healthy, prosperous, and joyful people. What began as a theory, today, 5 years later, Land of Good is not only a theory anymore, because there are 336 communities here in Holland and Belgium that are actually already successfully realizing the economic part of Land of Good. Testing my theory on their experience, I can see that the economy my team and I created for Land of Good is working. And this makes me eager to share it with the ones who are interested in a better life, a better reality. Because today many among us are looking for the new solutions to our many problems. The current system that runs our world for ages is jammed and corrupted in its own principles. The principles of money and banking, countries and borders, social security and globalization, internet and mass media. This is a control system that works very well only for 2% of the population that owns all the world's wealth. And no wonder, because hierarchy, domination and control are in the very nature of the masculine, of the great masculine. It would be fair to say that we are living in a male-driven world, in so-called patriarchy. Everything is controlled by a male leader. But if there is a great masculine, there must also be the great feminine. Because we are dual creatures, we experience our reality exclusively through the duality. Therefore, the foundation of Land of Good should be the principle of duality instead of male principle. It should be the principle of the golden balance between the masculine and the feminine, the harmony. The great feminine is not per definition applied to the female gender only. Of course, due to biological and social reasons, women are more prone to femininity. But because we are dual creatures, everyone has both masculine and feminine energies. So men should not assume that the great feminine has nothing to do with them. However, it's not about men or women, genders or sexes, but about the different qualities and abilities that the great feminine can offer. This doesn't mean that men must become more feminine either. It means other resources that would complete the full potential of our species. Through the millennia, the great masculine has been very well represented in our world society. We can easily identify it as the realization of the external physical and mental abilities that serve to the comprehension and exploration of the material world through the individual endeavor. But when it comes to the great feminine, we seem to have a blurred, distorted view. But if we want to create a social structure that would work for everybody, and if duality is our main principle, then it's extremely important to solve the identity crisis of the feminine first. After 5 years of looking for the meaning of the other half, I'm finally ready for the definition of it. The great feminine is the realization of the inner guidance system to its full potential and in full awareness of collective universal oneness. So if we use this definition as the basis for the identification of the great feminine, we will get the following features, which in their turn specify how exactly the great feminine should be represented in the reality that we are building on harmony between masculine and feminine. So as you can see, the great feminine is about the non-physical, eternal, invisible intelligence of the universe. It's about what we feel and not what we think or do. Is there something practical in it for us? Yes, there is, and a lot. Apparently, the Great Feminine has a potential to lead us to the discoveries of free energy sources, to the new technologies and the new realities, which will be beneficial for all of us and the planet. I know it might sound unreal for some of us, but if Universe brought you to this video, she has plans with you. Get ready to be ready. We will get to the non-material, magical part of the Great Feminine later. For now, because we are still the products of material world, it's only natural that we want to take care of our economic condition first, because many of us are worried about the financial situation. And it makes me happy that I can offer a concrete, real, proof to be working economy of Land of Good, which I will be happy to explain in more details in the next following video. Thank you.